Postmaster Nicholas Zip would be attempting speech number 9, which would be the second last part of the manual. Toastmasters Nicholas Yip will be taught to swing with power. Toastmasters Nicholas Yip is a computer programmer, and when I asked him what is his passion in life, he actually cited a few things, one of which was actually blogging, and to blog to the extent that he wants to make it as one of his other passions in life. Today, he is citing that we live in so much of a negativity that is influencing us so ever greatly. So in this assignment, Postmaster Nicholas Yip will challenge us to think thoughts in the other direction and to look at things positively. So let's welcome Postmaster Nicholas Yip as he shares with us his positive thoughts. Postmaster Nicholas Yip.
Everyone crazy. Also, the press needs to be going on it because bad news sells. But what should be done is an attitude change. You should make a vertical line going up. Make things positive. If that horizontal line, it looks lazy, it looks monotonous, it's stagnant. You won't get anywhere with negativity. So, to progress, you gotta shift your focus upwards. This is by adding a simple line, making it a positive symbol. A lot of people have had this positive attitude. The Japanese people, when the devastating earthquake in March of this year, they held a positive attitude. I spoke to one of them during an environmental fair, and they said they look to every day as if it would be a better day, and they strive towards it. They don't give up. That is why you have to look at Japan now, you have to look at the pictures. They have cleaned up everything. They have strived to get themselves back on track. They know that earthquakes are going to happen. Earthquakes is just a part of their life, but it doesn't let them have a negative attitude. Also, there's this guy called Nick Bullshit. He's an Australian, just like you, and has the same name. He was born with no arms and no legs, but he's a motivational speaker. He keeps a positive attitude, and he strives to instill the positive attitude into the people he speaks to. He's a counselor, so. And how does he do that? I don't know. But he likes to get around. He likes to serve. He likes to do all sorts of things that we do. But he doesn't have any arms. He's born with no arms. He's born with no legs. But it's a positive passion that keeps him going. Another person is the late Steve Jobs. He saw the potential in creating the positive potential in making personal computing a tool to unleash our creativity. He didn't see it as something negative, although some people have perceived him as negative. And when he was alive, of course, he received a lot of criticism. But after he died, a lot of people realized his positive attitude in turning just a simple machine into a center for creativity and spawning a lot of other devices around it, like the iPad and the iPhone and things that allow us to be creative, to shoot things, to video things, to record our memories. He's interested in grabbing memories. He's interested in people using it to preserve their memories, preserve their thoughts. with the use of these devices. He didn't perceive them as a threat. Mark Zuckerberg perceived Facebook as a positive means of sharing our life, of course, as a way of recording our memories. He didn't perceive it as, well, something to begrudgingly moan about. Of course, there are some people who really don't like Facebook now because it's so privacy intrusive. But like what he said during the table topic, it is a platform to communicate. You treat it positively. So, all we need is just a change in direction. Change in direction upwards. And you find that if you put positivity into your life, you find that you actually progress in life, you actually make progress. Instead of saying, I can't do this, drop the possibility, say, I can do it. Instead of saying, I won't do this, just say, I will do it after some research. I will find out a way to do it. Now, there's a will, there's a way. Now, keep positive. Keep strong and stir up a passion for life by just changing direction, changing attitude, instead of being stagnant all the time. Instead of being monotonous all the time, instead of thinking this is bad, that is bad. Think of the good things. Think of the good that has come out of everything. Like, I'm glad that I left the job, and now I'm in a better job. It's like, well, not like other people will say that I'm not happy, but I'm not happy that I left the other job, now I've got to work again. Now, I like my job. It's better. You leave for better things if you have to. You don't have to stay in the rut, you don't have to be flat. Just be positive. Stay positive and be passionate in whatever you do. So with this, I conclude. Instead of being negative, instead of being stagnant, change direction and just be positive. Thank you.
Nicholas Yip's attempt at persuading with power. How did he fare? The best part about this is you stay on longer, yes, you actually see the intelligence.
Tell me to welcome our first speech evaluator. He is a good friend of mine whom I extended the invitation to Scope International, and as I mentioned, it brings a fresh air to our respective evaluation and improving ourselves. So please join me to welcome competent communicator Ruben, President of Stroke. Thank you, my good friend, Dr. Nick, for giving this opportunity to be an evaluator for one of the speakers. Nicholas, what I can say about you right now is, because this speech project has a word conviction, sincerity, so in my conviction, I actually want you to be a competent communicator because you are practically on the last leg right here to become one. You can see it already. You can see you standing right in front here without any notes. You can carry yourself very well. You're already an established speaker. But we are doing speech number 9. So at this point, more is actually expected from you because at this point. So now you are supposed to present a persuasive speech and you choose a topic which is more motivational speech. Okay, so now we would like to give a motivational speech for this speech project. Now, this is how I would see it. Now, if you want to motivate someone, if you want to persuade someone, he has to come from you. So when I see you come out right in front there, and you use a prop right there, and say, this is positivity. Now, when you want to persuade someone, the positivity should come from you. But there are quite a number of times I see you standing in front, and you're looking over there. The positivity is not coming from you, but it's coming from the board. Like, as if you look there for inspiration. So when you give a motivational speech, you are actually writing your heart on the sleeve. Your heart on your sleeve. Some of the quotes that you mentioned or stories that you use, like the man without the arms and leg, when he gives a motivational speech, you can see young girls were coming up at him and they were hugging him and they were crying because there's so much of positivity coming from him and he can live a full life without his arms and his legs. So here's the thing, when you come up right here, you have to use your story. What have you done? And when you use other people's stories like Steve Jobs, you may use him as an example for positivity, but some people will remember him. He's not just a guy who got fired from his own company because he's such a demanding boss. And if you quote also the founder of Facebook, and especially when the movie came out, I've not seen the movie, but this is what the feedback I got from the people. You use him as an example for a positive role model, but a lot of people don't have a very high opinion of him when the movie came out because he obviously lacked character. But that's another story altogether. So now what I can say is, as a speaker, what I'm going to do here, I'm going to use a sandwich method. So I'm going to use a tuna sandwich. So if your speech is like a tuna sandwich, I find your speech that you need to put in more tuna, less mayonnaise. So what I'm trying to say is, your speech seems to be less persuasive, but more storytelling, which is again, I want to see that. So nonetheless, we still do have a tuna sandwich, but my word advice is, put more tuna and a little bit less mayonnaise. With that, back to you.
Ladies and gentlemen, qualifying statement as always. Evaluation is of a personal feedback. But when we share our evaluation, it's with the interest of helping each of us improve. So it's for Nicholas to perceive what is the value from this evaluation, and he can choose to enlist your help as well, based on, for example, what Alan shared earlier, a piece of paper in front to share those notes of information.